Alright everyone, today we're going to take on Ultramarines, specifically Second Company colors here. We've picked out a Primaris Intercessor, and we're going to get working on him shortly. This is going to be primarily airbrush work for the first bit, and then we'll move into some traditional brushwork and freehand. Let's get started with our airbrushing by first getting out Dark Prussian Blue from Vallejo Model Color. And this is a great base tone, very deep, very saturated blue. It almost looks a little purplish sometimes on a camera, just depending on how the white balance is. But we're going to start with this, and we're going to get a nice saturated layer over the entire mini. Next thing we're going to do is get out our blue by Pro Acryl. It's our mid-tone, and we're going to start working that into the armor plates, focusing more on where the light's going to be showing, and this is really where you set how harsh your gradient and transition is. We're going to go for something fairly dark in the shadows and fairly bright in the highlights. For our final step, we're going to bring in Pro Acryl Sky Blue and get those final highlights worked out. This is going to desaturate some of our blues a little bit farther than what I want, but that's okay. Final airbrushing step, we're going to bring in some transparent blue by Pro Acryl, and I'm going to take a very thin amount of this and spritz the entire mini and resaturate in where the sky blue made it a little bit too frosty, a little bit too white. And we're going to bring that back down to a nice neutral blue. This also saturates the rest of the model. All right, at this point, we're going to start bringing in some of our metallic tones. We're going to start off with some Regency gold. We're going to get all of the trim here. Our Second Company Ultramarines have nice gold trim. And then once we're blocked in, we're going to use Renaissance Gold to make some nice shines later on. And we're also going to work in various bits of matte black from the Army Painter into the cabling and joints of the Ultramarine as we go. Thank you. the gold on the Aquila, we're going to bring in, and before we highlight it out with the Renaissance gold, we're actually going to use a little bit of our Magimix, which is a mixture of equal parts Nuln Oil, Agrax, Earthshade, and Lahmian Medium, and shade in a bits of the parts here where it's a little bit more recessed so we can bring out the tips of the Aquila itself, and you'll see that in a moment. We're going to use a little bit of Carrick Stone and Ulthuan Gray to work up the skull on the shoulder pad of our Ultramarine here. A little bit of that Magimix will be handy for reinforcing the eyes and the ridges on the skull itself, but nothing major. It's a very simple detail, but something that we want to pick out. Here you can see that I'm hitting the tips of the wings here. Brings them out just a little bit more. Hit the top of that skull in the middle. And we're going to hit the tops of the bands on the shoulder pads as well. Remember, this is the Renaissance gold from Darkstar. All right, we're going to be knocking out a few different details in this next step. We're going to start off with blue steel and pewter to highlight on some of the silver metallics that we need to put in here. Remember, there's some pipes on his face mask. There's some bits on the bolter rifle, and there's also the knife blade that we're going to be hitting with these metallics. We're also going to be reusing our golds from before and the Magimix to get the rounds, as well as the half, I don't know what that thing is, the thing with the skull and the wing, the half Aquila on the side of the bolt rifle. And then we'll use a bit of our Stegadon scale green, matte black, and sky blue to do edge highlighting along the black haft of the bolter, as well as the black handle of the knife. Use the two tones between blue steel and pewter to get some highlights on both the knife blade and the edge of the bolt rifle, and definitely make sure you try to blend these, try to make that gradient like you would any other paints, and get some of that cross reflection across the blade. start playing around a little bit with the black things on his belt as well. He's got a couple of little bits hanging around the belt, a holster, a pouch. I bring in some of the Stegadon scale green and again the sky blue. I try to keep them light and I try to blend in a little bit of the Stegadon scale green, but I go mostly for a black tone here. It's pretty desaturated. So here's where things get a little bit interesting. I'm going to use mixes of my pants blue and sky blue, both from Pro Acryl, here to do some edge highlighting in various spots. I want to make sure I get some shines here. A little bit of roughness, a little bit of texture is not a bad thing, but I try to keep the edge highlights light and crispy and try not to go too heavy in on them. If you do make a mistake, don't be afraid to take it back down to your dark tone. There's a few areas where I screw up on my blue, both here and in the next few steps. Which I'll explain, unfortunately. you can see I'm taking it very light, very, very easy, nothing too major, hitting where the light is going to hit the most, and again, using various bits and blends here. If it looks a little too much, take it back down. If it looks a little too light, take it up. You can even go all the way back down to black, and if you really want to, and I think I may have used it a few times here, but not quite remembering, may have mixed in a little bit of my Ulthuan gray into that sky blue for a few extra pops on some of the edges and points. Nothing wrong with that at all. You don't have to get every edge, but you definitely want to get some prominent ones that are visible, and the face is a very good place to start with that. It usually draws a lot of the attention. So from here, I'm going to get the eye lenses. We're going to do a quick workup. This is actually three different paints. Burnt Red, Bold Pyrrole Red, and Flash Gitz Yellow. We're going to use these three paints together very quickly to get the eye lenses knocked out, and it's a slight mix of the yellow with the Bold Pyrrole Red for the final highlight and touch. And we hit this last little bit of cabling and tubing and joins with a little bit of our matte black before we step into freehand territory. The next step is actually going to be doing some freehand on both shoulders. I did all the freehand on both the shoulder pads. We've done the Ultramarine icon on one and the tactical marking on the other, along with the second company indicator in Roman numerals. Regardless, we used Pro Acryl Dark Warm Gray, Pro Acryl Light Warm Gray, and matte black to do that. We blocked it in with the dark warm gray, filled it in with the light warm gray, and then did the markings with the matte black. So that just leaves us with a base. All we have to do is base this. Alright. So let me just get one of these secret weapon bases, and I've added a little bit of those Pro Acryl dark and warm grays, a little bit of lining, some of the same blues and metallics, and we created a quick ultramarine base. This is from Secret Weapon Miniatures. And that's how you do an ultramarine second company. Thanks for joining me this week. I'll be back again next week with another video, and I'll see you on the weekends on Twitch. Till then, paint some minis.